Let's take a look at the Honda E user interface. The most important details of the car are shown in the driver display. It's a small display behind the wheel. Electronic rear view mirrors are positioned at the left and right hand side of the car. They can be adjusted like conventional mirrors. In addition to the driver display and the rear view mirror displays, the car has two additional displays positioned in the middle of the dashboard. The content of the displays can be navigated by pushing big buttons on the left and right hand side of the displays. The content of the displays can also be switched by pressing an on-screen button. So let's take a closer look at the functions of the displays. The displays can be used to access the settings of the car, to use the multimedia system including an HDMI input. There are also Honda apps available, navigation system, telephone system and MacRarium. The car has an internet connection but it didn't work on this test drive. The driver display can be customized by using the controls on the steering wheel. It can also be used to access the safety features of the car. Unfortunately, the display is not used in its fullest. There should be more text and explanations, and a small Honda E in the middle of the screen should also be bigger. Here you can see how you can customize the on-screen content. Unfortunately, it's hard to understand what you activate or deactivate. Now you can see what assistant systems are active or inactive, and which belts, seat belts are on and off. There's also an on-screen menu for the consumption of the car. Let's take a closer look at this. You see 23.1 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometer is a lot of energy compared to a BMW i3. I get this consumption when driving 130 kilometers per hour. So I think it's a rather high consumption. A button on the turn signal stalk can be used to display lines inside rear view mirror display. On the right hand side, a button can be used to activate the camera system. There's a 360 degree camera system and different camera displays can be merged and separated by pressing on screen buttons. It would have been nice if the 360 degree camera view would have used more screen real estate. The assistant features can also be customized by using the big display. And finally, there's a parking pilot button on the dashboard, which can be used to park the car and to depark the car. The car can be driven in normal or sport mode. It's interesting that the range does not change when changing the drive mode. One pedal driving can be activated by pressing a button on the center console. An icon is displayed in the driver display. A very useful feature of the advanced model is a power outlet, which can be used to connect normal appliances. It has to be activated by pressing a button. The electronic rear view mirror is also unique to the advanced model. In my opinion, it's difficult to use because it gets dirty rather easily and it's also not focused to infinity, so you have to change your focus when driving, which might be a problem if you have to use glasses.